You know, I'm not really sure what I intended for this whole experience. I've done three takes of this now, and it's not turning out like I had planned. So I may have to change my format at least for this one. Here's the road to Comic-Con. Kind of part two, well, actually technically part one of my whole experience because I did journey today. So here's how my day began.
Hi. It's Wednesday, October 12th at 7:51 in the morning. I've already been up since 5:30 this morning, and I didn't go to bed until 2 in the morning. I'm tired. And this is my road to Comic-Con.
And yeah, that's pretty much all I did. I thought I would film myself probably at what I thought would be my lowest point of the day. Very tired. Very, very tired. But then I took a shower. I felt better. I got more energized.
All right. My throat still feels kind of hoarse, but I feel a lot cleaner, a lot more awake, even though I haven't slept any more yet. And waiting to leave until I catch my flight. I leave like in about an hour. And then my flight is at 12:50. So I'll have like 2 hours to kill at the airport. Didn't consider that.
And yeah, I was pumped. I was ready to go. It just took a while to wait because, well, I had someone driving me to the airport, so I had to wait. And it gave me time to finish packing. And that's really all I did this morning was just make sure I had everything packed, electronics and all that stuff. My hair's gonna start getting messed up because I'm messing with it and stuff. But finally the time came to leave, and
Okay, well, it's 10:04, and I think we're about to leave to take me to the airport. And I'm getting just kind of the final essentials packed away. I've gotten, the laptops, the cameras, well, laptop, not taking laptops, just the last minute things I'm using until I'm going. And I'm kind of looking at these going like, wow, things have changed a bit. Like when I was little, I would go on a trip. I would have a Game Boy, which had batteries. A CD player, which had batteries, and maybe a charger for a phone, and then eventually a laptop. So like two chargers for five electronics, four electronics. Anyway, so look at this now, and I've got, okay, well, there's a laptop cable. All right, well, there's that one. I need that one. Charger for my Zune. I definitely would need that. Don't need that. Batteries for the mouse, but whatever. Charger for the video camera. That's important. Sync cable for the video camera, so I can get video off of it while I'm there. And a charger for my phone. And a charger slash link cable for my picture camera, I guess you would say. Stuff. And it's kind of makes me wonder like what's happened, because I now have this messenger bag that's packed full of electronics and junk. And I could leave it here. I could. This is not things that I need to survive, but this is my life now. This is what I've become. A bag full of electronics. And then a suitcase of clothes and like when I was little, I would pack clothes. Just clothes. Now I've got clothes. Now I've got toiletries, as they call them, the shampoos, conditioners, hairspray, toothbrush, toothpaste, cologne, deodorants, mouthwash, ginger pills because I get motion sickness. lactates because I'm lactose intolerant and I refuse to stop eating dairy. Vitamins, like, kind of feel like an adult. I don't like it. So, off to the airport, and I'm hoping I can film in the airport. I've never tried to film in an airport, so I don't know if I'll be rushed, but if anything I've learned from Shay Carl over these years is that you can film anywhere. At least if you're Shay Carl. So, off to the airport I go.
So yeah, as you can probably guess, I didn't get very much filmed at the airport. I don't know how people like Shay Carl can do it. I didn't even really try because I was nervous and I didn't want to have some random security guy tackling me. But I'm here. I'm in New Jersey, actually. My hotel's in Jersey that I'm going to Manhattan, which I found out is a horrible idea because it's very expensive. So my mood right now is kind of because I'm not really feeling well. And two, I found that I'll probably be paying double what I had anticipated in traveling. So that's fun. But the airport, it's an experience. Like, you walk through it, and I was surprised by what I saw because, you know, you got a Burger King. I knew that would be there. You know, McDonald's, a Starbucks, you know, just stuff. But what I didn't expect was, one, a Best Buy Express. Basically like a vending machine. Probably the size of two or three. It was pretty big. Stocked with, I guess, what any traveler would need, like SD cards, iPhones, or, well, iPod Touch, really. iPods, Super Mario for the DS, headphones, cables, chargers. I saw the little charging pad for the DS. Lots of stuff. And I'm not sure if you can even hear me. I'm trying to keep my voice kind of calm because I don't know who's around me. Who's listening in? But that was kind of weird, seeing that kind of thing. I wish I had at least gotten a picture of that. But then, of course, I would have been there with a weird guy taking a picture of a vending machine. So that wouldn't have worked. But later on, I found out there was a Chili's to-go booth, which seems weird. Chili's is a restaurant, for those of you who may not have one near you. But just this kind of a little booth, and with wrapped, like, turkey wraps, sandwiches, random things. I swear if they had a Bloomin' Onion or an Awesome Blossom, whichever, and one's Outback, if they had one there, that would have tempted me. That's probably my favorite thing to get at Chili's, and probably the least healthy thing to get there. But it was weird seeing Chili's food, you know, on little shelves, like at a deli, and you can pick out what you want and that kind of stuff. That was weird, but it was nice. I got me a Starbucks, and I have not had Starbucks in a very long time, so I was really, really doing the whole, I finally, I think, settled on like a caramel frappuccino, which made my friend really upset because that's so plain, it's boring, but it was tasty. The flight itself, my plane was like, they said an hour late leaving, but I think it was like 20 minutes late for us to get on. Wasn't bad. I have not flown, like I said, I thought it was 5 years, it's actually been 4 years, but same difference. But the flight was nice. Like, I did get a little bit of footage of just outside of the whole thing. Like, I really do like flying. I just never really do it. You know, just that whole feeling when you're taking off and you just feel like yourself rising and then just being above the clouds, it was absolutely stunning. I did get little video clips of the flight, and just, it was an experience, you know, just traveling. I did have my Zune to watch stuff on, so that kept me kind of busy, but I don't like sitting still for a very, very long time. I got kind of fidgety, and I wanted to get out and break free and scream there's something on the wing, but they probably wouldn't have liked that. But the flight itself was like, you know, two hours ish. There was a delay landing, so I think we were sitting there on the runway for half an hour longer than we should have been, which was nice and fun. Walking around, my feet look weird from my shoes. Walking around the airport. I was surprised at how friendly so some people were. Like, I was told in New York, like, really unfriendly, really just kind of get where you're going, that kind of thing. Which does kind of work for later on. But then, anyway, people at the airport were very, very friendly. I did skip the whole check-in thing. When you get to the airport, you do security. I had a full body scan done, so I feel really sorry for the security guard who had to monitor that. I'm sorry. But that was interesting. I thought it would be, you know, it was either that or get a pat down. And not on the first date. No. But it was interesting. But yes, found my luggage pretty easily. It was funny because at baggage claim, I flew in American Airlines, so I'm walking through baggage claim, and I get to this one thing, and it's completely empty, and I see, like, United on the side. I'm like, oh, that's not me. This one guy just, I think he was, like, a chauffeur waiting for something. He had a little sign and everything. He's like, you're looking for American Airlines? I'm like, yeah. Way down there, at the end, to the right. I was like, and he was right. It was right at the end. I don't know if he knew the plane schedules and knew that American Airlines had just landed or what, but that was really awesome. My bag was, like, right there waiting for me. It was like it was fate. That could have been a guardian angel looking out for me. So that was nice. And that's really, you know, that's about it. Like, I found a cab, and I said I was going to Jersey, and the guy was like, oh. On my taxi fare finder thing, like, I checked two of their websites, and they said it would be, like, $30-ish to get from the airport to my hotel in Jersey, which I was fine with. That'd be great. And, no. It was double that, plus tip. Plus toll booths along the way. And my mood was starting to just drop. And one thing that's happened, like, recently, like, within the past 2 years, I've started getting, like, motion sickness from long car rides. And sometimes it's okay. Sometimes it's, you know, it's no big deal. I don't have my license because I have anxiety. Like, me behind the wheel of a car, I can drive okay, but I don't trust myself behind, like, the wheel of a car. I definitely couldn't do it up here. Like, back home, back in Zimbabwe, where I'm from, for those of you who aren't in the know, we use turn signals. When we turn, like, we wait until there's an opening, put the signal on, we scoot on over. It's a nice process. When we get to a crosswalk, if the little man's there, you walk across. If the hand is there, you wait, because that hand is saying, that's not what it's like here. It wasn't just my cab driver, it was everybody. Cutting around, I think he had his turn signal on once, and that kind of freaked me out a little bit. Because we're just cutting through traffic, you know, cars kind of halfway this way, he just kind of goes around, and I'm just sitting there like, oh God, I'm feeling sick. I started feeling worse and worse the more we went, and just people, like, the crosswalk was a stop sign, people were walking across, you know, he would go a little way, and if a person was already there, he would stop, let them pass, and he would keep going, and other people would be, like, waiting for him to go, and it's just busy, 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 like, there's no stopping, there's no waiting, there's no your turn, my turn, it's just... And I don't like it. And I was supposed to be back in my hotel by, like, 3 o'clock, I think. Maybe 4 at the latest. And my plan was to go to the convention, because today is, like, the... If you have a 4-day pass, this is, like, their pre-show day where you can get in, buy your stuff. Which I had planned to get in there today, buy all of my crap, and then be done with it. But... It's 5 o'clock now. Traffic is absolutely horrible. I was in the car for at least an hour. Traffic is terrible. And it's starting to rain. And I'm just not feeling good. I'm tired because I haven't gotten sleep. I'm feeling like motion sickness kind of all in me. So that's just not fun. And kind of bummed because this is supposed to be the big start to Comic-Con, and I'm feeling queasy. Not great. But this is part one. This is the road to Comic-Con. I'm not at Comic-Con yet. The show officially starts tomorrow. And I hope to see some of you guys there. I found out Vangelis is going to be there. I'm actually excited to meet Vangelis. I really am. Didn't think he was going to be there. So that will be interesting. I'm going to meet with a couple of friends. Nitro Streak, a.k.a. Flame War, a.k.a. Rachel, a.k.a. whatever other name she has. She has tons of names. I'm going to meet her there. I'm going to meet Callie, the woman who makes the Puggles. Puggles are the big hits. I'm going to get to meet her. So that sounds fun. Kind of want a Puggle. Maybe I can try to con one out of her. I don't know. But I really have no idea what's in store for tomorrow. There's not really anything on my schedule, so I'll probably do buying. I'll probably buy stuff tomorrow. And I'm technically at Comic-Con. Like, I'm, across the bridge from where it is, but tomorrow should have a lot more footage, a lot better stuff of the actual show. So I'm sorry this video, I'm sure it's probably really boring, and I feel bad, because I had this whole build-up. I have this whole thing in my head of what this would be, and this isn't really it. So I'm sorry I'm not entertaining. I'm sorry if you can't even really hear me. I'm going to feel really dumb if you can't hear any of this. So yeah, this is a new ending, because the last one really wasn't good. And it's getting cut, but I'm gonna go. This last bit of video here is a little treat. This is pretty much, if you saw the condo tour from like 2 years ago, this is basically a sequel to the condo tour. Me showing off my room at my hotel. Not a single bit of dialogue is spoken in it, so that's nice for starters. And I'm gonna go set up my computer. Figure out why a package wasn't waiting for me when I got here, and probably get dinner soon. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope tomorrow will be a lot more entertaining. If you're at Comic-Con, let's meet up. Let's see. Let's talk. Let's talk about toys. You like toys? I like toys. Okay. I keep looking at the screen. I know I shouldn't, but I'm gonna go. So see you guys. Thanks for watching me being me, which isn't really a good thing. So yeah, see ya.
With over 180 new and newly renovated hotels, you can enjoy our redesigned guest rooms and vibrant social spaces around the world. Keep connected with our innovative lounge, the Link at Sheraton, experienced with Microsoft, a social space in the heart of our lobbies, offering free Wi-Fi. Drift away in one of our 70,000 redesigned guest rooms, featuring our signature suite sleeper bed. Upgrade to our exclusive community, the Sheraton Club, where you can work or relax in the club lounge, and upgrade to a higher level of comfort and convenience.